Strepska Plesa in the Tatra Mountains. This is where Vladimir Zagrovsky of Bulgaria celebrated the most important victory of his career. The ski jumper, helped by his father and coach, snatched the gold medal and opened a new chapter in ski jumping for his country.
It was important not only for me,
but also for Bulgaria, because it was the second medal in winter sport. And it's also important for ski jumping, because it's becoming more and more popular. The 21-year-old sports student has World Cup experience, and he knew he had a chance of winning. In round one, Zagrovsky made an excellent jump of 95 meters, certainly better than in practice, because he followed the advice of the FISU technical delegate, Austria's Paul Ganzenhuber. I gave him some tips because I saw him in practice, and he made some mistakes that he could easily correct. And I told him if he did that, he could finish first. And he's won today because he's done everything right. Zagrovsky had been doing a lot of his training in Austria, and that helped. Now he needed to stay mentally focused before that final round. With 94 meters this time and a total of 248.8, Zagrovsky was the number one, ahead of the Russian duo Ilmir Hazatdinov and Evgeny Klimov. It's really very nice, you know, because over the last 2 years I had problems with my shape. It was getting worse. And now it's getting better, so we'll see. But for me, it was a great day today.
And gold medal.
A great day for his coach as well, the former Olympic ski jumper Emil Zagrovsky, proud of the performance of his son. My father was a ski jumper. 12 years ago, it was in Samokov, and they had a small hill there, hill of some 40 meters. And there my father started his career as a ski jumping coach. And one day, he came up to me and said, "If you want, you can come and have a look." And that's when everything started. Junior world champion in 2011, frequently in the World Cup top 20, his best World Cup season was 2 years ago, before a back injury slowed his progress. But Vladimir knows that he can count on the support of his father always. We have some problems together sometimes, but we can also work together in a very good manner. And he helps me a lot in my sport, certainly. Yes, I have to thank my father. Vladimir wrote not only a little bit of history for his country, he also wrote another chapter in the sporting saga of his family. I'm a very dedicated athlete. I love my sport. I'm doing everything for my passion, biathlon, and I worked hard to be here.
J'ai fait beaucoup de choses pour arriver ici. Il y a des moments très
There are some difficult moments and some delightful moments.
Aussi. I used to bite my tongue and hold my breath.
An event like the Universiade is very important for us to value our work as athletes and as students. It's very important for me to represent my country and the values of the students as well. Her name is Victoria Parial. She's a Spanish biathlete from Granada, competing at the Winter Universiade in Slovakia. A 26-year-old student has had to struggle to follow her dream of being an athlete in a country where she doesn't have a lot of support.
Victoria
is physically no better than other athletes. She's rather an average athlete physically, but she has strength of character. She's especially consistent at a high level. She's always giving herself challenges, and even if she fails, she wants to go further, higher, always. Victoria started with cross country, then she discovered biathlon just a few years ago. But training for biathlon in the south of Spain, in Andalucía, is quite a challenge. To win a medal in this sport requires so much, and it's almost impossible. It really is difficult. But we made it last year. In fact, we got 3 medals, one at the Summer World Championships and 2 others at the European Championships. She was runner-up twice in the sprint and the pursuit. But it really is a challenge, because Victoria started in biathlon only in 2008, which means she started at the age of 19. Since 2008, during competitions, Alexandra Napa has worked from 6 o'clock in the morning until 11 at night, always available to prepare the equipment and to coach Victoria. And he works without assistance. We'll never be like the Norwegians with a lot of technicians, or like the Austrians and the Russians who have 30 or 35 technicians for just 4 athletes taking part. And you can imagine if there are 35 people, it tells you there's a lot of work to do in terms of the preparation of the skis, the physical preparation of the athlete. It's a sport like Formula One, where you can win it in the paddock. At the psychological level, it's difficult to be just a two-person team doing a lot of work, because biathlon is a very technical sport. Victoria Padiel came to the University Games with a lot of ambition. Her strength is normally the shooting, but this time, during the 15-kilometer race, she skied fast but missed with the rifle 6 times and finished 17th, well behind the winner, Alina Rykova from Kazakhstan. But there was a reason for her underperformance. We've just competed in the sprint at the Biathlon World Cup at Antholz. Right afterwards, we took the car to come here. A 10-hour drive, and you know, I'm tired. Victoria was disappointed. She expected much more from her first Winter Universiade competition. We didn't have enough time to prepare the kit. I had no time to practice here, but okay, there are still 3 races to come. The next day, the Spanish sports student was on the shooting range, working with a rifle, practicing to be fast, to move smoothly, to freeze before pulling the trigger, to be accurate. Victoria was determined to do better in the next race. She's really going to go for it, you know, and she wants to make amends because she didn't succeed in the individual race. She will want to prove that the medals of last year were not won by luck. And, you know, I think she's got a lot of fighting spirit that'll make her grow wings, if you like. And I think it's going to work for her. It was the 7.5-kilometer sprint, and the local heroine, Paulina Fialkova, was in great shape. And Victoria, well, despite all that practice, she had 10 misses in the shooting, and she'd finish down in 35th place. 3:35 behind Fialkova, her problems continued. In the pursuit, Victoria would come 17th behind the Russian winner, Evgenia Pavlova. And in the 12.5-kilometer mass start, she was well behind the Czech winner, Jitka Landova. 14th place for Victoria this time, her best results. The others help you in giving you that necessary motivation day by day, every day. And certainly, her optimism is undimmed. Supported by her family and by her coach, she's trying to combine the physical and the academic demands as best she can. At Granada University, it's not easy, you know, because there's not a special program to help top-level athletes. But I think the difficulties there have helped me, really, to become stronger mentally and to battle harder, to get to a higher standard. Because the path to get there is definitely not an easy one. Being self-financed for the past 4 years, the team of two will continue to strive. And after the Universiade, while Victoria continues her studies, their next challenge is to be part of the top 30 in the Biathlon World Cup. emerging camper sport. And coming next, the alpine skier winning a medal against all the odds. And the fierce but friendly rivalry of two snowboarders. In just a moment.
Education meets sport and culture.
On your mark.
What best promotes excellence in mind and body? Where do friendship, integrity, and achievement meet? Which event gathers the best student athletes from around the world? The Universiade, the home of international university sports. Today's stars, tomorrow's leaders.